space hog.
Coach, just going back down there, I mean, if you watch the film, like, did you show the guys the film from up here, and if so, just kind of what jumps out?
Well, this will be the first day because we had off yesterday, but we'll show clips of the game. We won't show the whole game off. It's a long time. We did that first game, but just a breakdown on our part. First half, thought we did a great job defensively and offensively. Second half, just a tremendous amount of breakdown, allowing the guys to get to the lane, not protecting on the backside. And then we looked slow offensively, got stagnant. So we'll watch film on the breakdowns, things we need to correct, but we won't watch the whole game.
And coming off the game against Georgia where you felt like contain a man was one of the best things you guys did. I mean, is that got to be a positive going down?
Oh, without a doubt. The thing I talked to our guys about is the consistency on both ends of the floor. Offensively, protecting that lane, weak side guys, helping and rotating, closing out hands up, containing the drill. And I thought we did a great job against Georgia, which a team that does a tremendous job of getting to the rim and getting offensive rebounds. So just for us, the consistency. We know what to do. It's just a matter of doing it from start to finish.
Also, the last time I played over there was the marathon game. What sticks out in your memory about that game?
Well, you know, I watched the film. We scored the ball. They did a great job of scoring the ball. We scored. We got enough stops. I thought Jarnell did a great job of getting big rebounds. Our guards did a great job of scoring. It's just one of those games that just we scored the most points. I don't know if the defense on either end was great, but I thought we did a great job of scoring the ball.
Kazo, how do you think your team is different from the first matchup with A&M, and what you see on film, how do you think they're different if they are at all?
They play the way they play. We play the way we play. But I think for us, to be specific, I'm not sure about those guys behind the scenes, it's just the consistency of it. The first half, we played well. The second half, we got to do the same. And it's on both ends of the floor. And I say it over and over again, but that's it, because when we carry out the scout report, the assignments from start to finish of games, we got a chance to be successful. Then offensively, when you make shots, you're a different team. I think that's with anybody. But again, I always go back to our guys. You got to defend, rebound, play hard, consume yourself with that. The shots will fall. They don't. You got to stay defending.
You guys ran off a few games this year, but in the SEC, ones that come down to single digits, I think it's one at the bottom. What would you like to see your guys do better in those games that go down to the wire?
Well, I think each game probably different. I go like one game at a time. Something probably different that happened. Most cases on defense, there was some breakdown. We, you know, offensive end, you probably didn't carry out assignments or execute. You didn't make shots. So it just depends on which game you're talking about.
Coach, with Antonio, I mean, obviously he had a great game the other night. Did you check with him before a game? Are you feeling it tonight? Is there any sense before you put him into the game whether he's got his stuff or maybe doesn't?
Well, he'll play him. He's a guy that can make shots. But, you know, to his credit, past 3 weeks, a month or so, he's been coming in at 10 o'clock in the morning working on his shot. And the shots fall. But just the consistency and the confidence. And I think when any guy that shoots balls, when you knock something down, you get the level of confidence, then this game opens up. Because he's a guy we need to make shots for.
It might have been a conference foe for a couple of years now. You got the first two games with them. One's four overtime, one they kind of steal from again. Do you feel this is kind of a developing rivalry a little bit?
Well, I don't know necessarily rivalry, but I just think it's, you know, a competitive team. They play hard, they compete. But I think, you know, rivalries build over time. We're talking about years and years of, you know, playing against an opponent. But for us, it's our third game against those guys. We try and do everything our power to get that win.
You come to expect so much out of Jarnell. I don't know that he had his most productive game last time against these guys. Was there something they did, or is it just one of his maybe off nights?
Well, I think in watching film, they collapsed a little bit. They doubled down. Sometimes their point guard ran at the ball. You know, most teams double with their big, opposite big. They ran with the point guard. So it just corrected those things. But I don't think he was as assertive, though. It wasn't a case of what so much they did. It was about how he approached the game, how he defended, how he posted up aggressively and making plays. And then again, you got to give him the ball to be aggressive.
Coach, Jarnell takes 13 shots the other night. Jordan takes five. You guys played maybe one of your best games for the year. I mean, is there a lesson there for the team? I mean, about like where your bread's buttered on offense?
Well, I think both of those guys have to score for us in order for us to be successful at the highest level. But they score the basketball. They take what the defense gives them. You got shots, you got to take them. But you got to pound the ball inside with Jaron and Jarnell. Those guys got to touch the ball around the rim. George scores his baskets, but you got to get that ball around the rim, especially when teams are double. Now it makes it easier for our perimeter guys.
Except for Barton the other night, Tennessee hadn't gotten an awful lot of scoring from the bench. Is that a concern that is going forward with this
not
team?
Not at all. Not at all. When you come off the bench, again, defend, rebound, play hard, and it can't be minuses when you leave the game. I mean, you want to leave the game with pluses as the guy that's coming off the bench. You can't have a lot of breakdown. You're not making shots, that's fine. You have guys on the floor that can make shots and make plays as long as you're not breaking down.
A couple of games on the road. I mean, just talk about end of the season, holding up under that kind of pressure, and what these two games, I guess, might mean for you?
Well, I think the greatest thing, you're playing one game at a time. You're preparing for Texas A&M, your game plan, figure out the best way to win that game, then you move forward to the next one. But I mean, road games are never easy, just from a mental standpoint, regardless of who you're playing, the talent level. There's always the mental approach when you're playing the road environment. So for us, it's preparing to win against A&M, then we move forward.
Coach, is this a strange trip to be in the league, but yet be so long? I mean, I guess it's the longest one of the year by far.
It is different, you know, it's different. But I guess the good thing about it is on a Saturday, you can get back. But you got to do what you got to do. It's good weather down there, so that's not too bad.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.